Okay, so I've got the, take the little bearings out. You put the bushings things in here for the rods. I guess I'll have to take those out. Got the housing here, I've got the axles. Set in the differential. I'm getting a 59.75 width on it. So we just gotta mock it all up and I can see how, what length to cut the tubes. I got some 3-inch pipes here. So let me try to tighten these up. Okay, so that's the bushing kit for the jig. This is the solid rod. You get this at any steel yard has it. I think it goes in one way better than the other. Let's try it. Okay, so that's what it looks like when you put it on there. So I've got this all set up the way it's supposed to go. And so that's it. Now we're just gonna put the ends on and we can start measuring whatever tube we need to do. Kind of slide that in there. It says 3.150 on these particular ends. I found these on eBay for 15-20 bucks. What it looks like. So this is a must have. These aren't expensive. I think I bought this a couple years ago. I think it was 10 or 20 bucks. ICT, good brand. It's what you need. Okay, so I'm getting 55 inches from the end of this to the end of that. So that means this surface here to this surface here has to be 55 inches too. So you put these little collars on here and that keeps the axle ends from moving out. Then you have to figure out the center here from your axles. On a 4.9 inch, the driver and the passenger side are different lengths because the pinion's off-centered, but this thing will tell you what you need to do. I don't know if I have them, but it'd be a good idea to make some spacers for this, or I'm just gonna eyeball it, really. This will be the fourth one I've made. But anyway, let me get this centered, and I'll show you in a second. Okay, well, I didn't have any long bolts, but I found this 3/8 rod, and this seems to do the trick pretty nice. Just kind of jammed them in here, and another thing doesn't move around so much. So again, trying to find pinion center, and then this is the length of each axle. You just kind of put your tape on it. And go center to center. And you can get your axle length. So I'm gonna do that next. Try to think about what that's supposed to be.
Okay.
So basically, with the axles out, measure them to the end of the bearing there. It's hard to tell with the phone. Kind of get 29 and a quarter. They don't sit all the way in. They kind of stick out a little bit, and then your brake backing plate goes over an eighth. So this is, I'm going to call this 29 and an eighth. And then from the top of this thing here, this is where your axles are. It says axle cut. So go from that. Your end towards about 29 and an eighth. And now you know where this is going to be. Excuse me. So to cut the tubes, this side is going to be about 13 and 3 eighths. And the other side here is going to be about 11 and a quarter. That's how I did it. See in here, I laid these things out, but it's about an inch and an eighth. So I've got about an inch and an eighth between the axles here. I've got a block just to make it a little straighter. And so, yep, I'll cut some axle tubes next. Okay, so I put this little metal square over there. Because a straight line is shorter than a curved one. And so that kind of corrected some weird numbers I was getting. I got 54 and a half. And so then put this in the axle area, go to the end of the flange and subtract about an eighth of an inch. So I got 29. 29. And go over here. 24 and a half, 24 and a half. All right, so finally the numbers make sense. I'm ready to measure for the tubes. 13 and a quarter, and 11 and 3 eighths. Push in on the end of your, I guess it was more. Probably is. Yeah. You know, we'll put the collar on one side of this thing. Right here.
It goes in that way?
It doesn't matter. Yeah.
Okay. Here, let's just. It doesn't matter, like, where the collar is. How about we give this a try? Did I have a little mallet somewhere? Let's. It kind of catches on that. This will be all time lapse. Just being filmed. They sound like munchkins.
I'll try to find some.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, so make sure your hardware is on correctly. Your axle ends are parallel with the differential. And learn this every time, gotta cut this one off and straighten it out so the wheel cylinders are parallel with the ground. Okay, so there it is. Make sure you leave the jig in place till you're done welding your hardware on. Otherwise, that can make it warp too.